morning, everyone. Welcome to Christ Lutheran Church, our very special children's program. Just a reminder, we're having a potluck after downstairs, so please stay and enjoy the goodies. We're having a party to celebrate Jesus's birthday, and Kat made a fabulous cake. There's a lot of it, so make sure you take some with you. We're going to start off today with our memory challenge verse on the first page of your bulletin. So if you'll read with me, please. You shall love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, and with all your mind. This is the great and first commandment. Matthew 22:37-38. Please rise and join us in singing the first Noel.
Please be seated.
In the first Genesis story, we hear that God turned the world with wind, and God said, "Let there be light." God said, "Let there be night and day." God said, "It is good." Then in the first chapter, in the Gospel of John, we hear now that wind is the world is with God and Jesus.
In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was in the beginning with God. All things came into being through him. Without him, not one thing came into being. What has come into being in him was life, and the life was the light of all people, the true light, which helps everyone see, was come into the world. Jesus was in the world, and the Word that shaped the world was in him. And yet the Word did not know him. He came to what was his own. His own people did not accept him. But to all who received not blood him, who believed in his name, he gave power to become children of God, who were born not of blood or flesh of will of man, but of God. It is Jesus, a child of God, who being close to the Father's heart has made God known.
In the first chapter of the Gospel of Luke, we learn of Mary's willingness to work with God, even though what is being asked of her will not be easy. Being pregnant when not married is against the rules set where and when she lives. There are some very hard consequences for breaking these rules, the worst consequence being death.
In the sixth month of Elizabeth's pregnancy, the messenger of God, Gabriel, was sent by God to a town in Galilee called Nazareth to an unmarried woman engaged to a man whose name was Joseph of the house of David. The young woman's name was Mary, and Gabriel said to her, "Greetings, favored one, the Lord is with you." But Mary was perplexed by his words and wondered what sort of greeting this might be. Gabriel said to her, "Don't be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor in God. And now you will be conceived, and now you will conceive in your womb and bear a son. And you will name him Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High, and the Lord God will give him the throne of his ancestor David. He will reign over the house of Jacob forever. Of his kingdom there is no end." Mary asked, "How can this be? I am unmarried."
The angel said to her, "The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. The child to be born will be holy. He will be called Son of God. For nothing will be impossible with God." Then Mary said, "Here am I, the servant of the Lord. Let it be with me according to your word." Then the messenger of God departed from her.
watching their flocks. There an angel stood before the shepherds, and the glory of the Lord shone all around all of them. And the shepherds were terrified. But the angels of the Lord said to them, "Do not be afraid, for see, I am bringing you good news of great joy for all the people. To you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, who is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign for you. You will find a child wrapped in bands of cloth and laying in a manger." Immediately after the angels stopped speaking, there were suddenly many angels praising God and saying, "Glory to the God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace among those whom he favors."
So the stable that Mary, Joseph, and Jesus were staying was, as you heard earlier, home to some of the animals of the village. These animals must have been pretty curious as to what a baby was doing in their feeding trough.
One, Now when the shepherds saw Mary, Joseph, and Jesus in the stable and saw that what the angel had said to them was true, they went out and made it known to whoever they met, which means it's very possible that some of the townspeople went to the stable that very night to see and maybe even help Mary, Joseph, and baby Jesus because of what the shepherds had told them.
Yay.